The 60s were in full swing and it was an era of social change. The Beatles had taken the world by storm and the Aussie dollar replaced the Australian pound. It was an exciting era and was a land of opportunity. By the end of the decade, scientific electronics was born. Operating during the evenings and weekends whilst all juggling full-time employment, Peter, Jill and their business partners Bill and Heather Whitburn created a business whose vision was to design a wide range of instrumentation including power supplies, frequency counters and digital multimeters. The new decade's early years were also a significant time in Australian history. Gough Whitlam became the country's first Labor Prime Minister since 1949. The Queen opened the Sydney Opera House, the Vietnam War ended, and so too did the Lloyd and Whitburn partnership. The Lloyds took control of scientific electronics, launching a range of standard communication-based power supplies. Everything was manufactured in-house, or should I state, in the Lloyd's garage. By 1974, the company had won two significant contracts, to design and manufacture defence power supplies for Collins Radio and for Ansett Airlines visual display terminals. These big wins meant the company had outgrown the garage. Subsequently, a small factory was rented in Bayswater's Barry Street to run the operation. To say life was busy during the 70s was an understatement. The company designed and produced a range of switching type DC-DC converters for the telecommunications industry, some of which are still produced today. And on the home front, a new branch of the Lloyd family was also in production. Louise Lloyd was born in 1973 and Sarah was welcomed to the world in 1974. Australia in the 1980s would be remembered for many things. Ash Wednesday fires devastated Victoria and South Australia, and a public holiday was declared after John Bertram led Australia 2 to victory in the America's Cup Challenge. The company had a small connection with one of the challengers, Kookaburra, and supplied a 100-watt DC-DC converter. The Lloyds developed a love of yachting, a passion that lives on today. Just a year after Peter Lloyd offered 5-year warranties on all company products, the company hit significant milestones in the production of power supplies and in 1984, Scientific Electronics was named a state finalist in the Victorian Small Business Awards. The business also gained accreditation and first UL approval for the ISO 9001. 1986 was a watershed year, not because of Crocodile Dundee hitting the cinemas, but because Scientific Electronics changed its name. And so, CTEC was born. The name change was considered a smart move, and by 1988, the country celebrated the nation's 200th birthday. CTEC secured a large contract with NEC and production began on the custom-designed Unisys power supply. The 1990s was a difficult period. Australia entered into the recession we had to have, but CTEC negotiated through the rough years through clever management, winning more contracts and nurturing existing OEM clients. CTEC became the first private company to offer safety compliance testing services for IT and telecommunications equipment, and this led on to secure contracts with major customers, including Alcatel, Aristocrat, AWA, Bull France, Fujitsu, Rescare and Siemens. In 1995, the company had in excess of 100 employees, and it was clear that the business needed a new home. In 1999, a new era for CTEC began when it relocated to a new purpose-built manufacturing facility at Knoxfield. As the world celebrated the new millennium and Sydney took centre stage hosting the 2000 Olympics, CTEC was also enjoying an exciting period. Louise Lloyd Bayliss joined the company and soon made an impact, helping CTEC to win new clients, Codan and Wagcom. Before long, Jayco, Australia's largest caravan manufacturer, joined the company's growing client base. In 2004, it became clear that Louise had honed her technical and management skills and was ready to take over the reins from her father, Peter. So a new CTEC era began, with Louise in the managing director's role. Meanwhile, Peter and Jill retreated to their farm, Carn Station, where they began their new, but not so quiet life. During this time, Sarah also joined CTEC and has performed many supporting roles over the years. During 2007, CTEC made the tough but strategic decision to move the company's volume manufacturing to a facility in Malaysia, while still maintaining a specialised production in Knoxfield. More change was implemented in 2009 when David Bayliss was appointed to the chief executive role, bringing with him a new vision for the company. Soon after David's appointment, CTEC was awarded certification for 20 years of quality management systems for the ISO 9001, and the company's Knoxfield manufacturing equipment was upgraded to world-class standard. The last couple of years have seen a new wave of firsts. The Drifter, a battery management device for Jayco's caravans. A new, unique design power supply for Ainsworth Gaming. CTEC also won a Globex grant to market BatteryCheck, a world-first wireless battery monitoring device. And this year, CTEC is launching its BM Pro range into the retail sector. So, as this milestone year is celebrated, this great Australian company, started and led through the years by an ambitious Aussie family, looks certain to have bright years ahead. And now, with grandchildren, Peter and Jill's dream of creating a successful, family-owned and operated company looks well and truly secure.